The latest now on the rift between members of the ruling PDP-Laban party, the faction of Senators Coco Pimentel and Manny Pacquiao denounced Saturday's National Assembly, which led to their ouster as Executive Vice Chairman and Party President. The assembly was organized by Energy Secretary Alfonso Cusi, who was earlier expelled from PDP-Laban by another faction. It was also attended by President Duterte himself. A Pacquiao ally points to presidential daughter Sara Duterte as the root of the disagreement between the party.
Ang punot-dulo nito, Julius, na totoo lang, alam mo rin, is between Sara Duterte versus Manny Pacquiao. Kasi akala nila, siya sabihin lang nila kay Manny, sumunod ka lang. Hoy, sumunod ka lang, ha? Na wag kang tumakbo, anak ko yan. Ang masakit dito, Julius, Ang perception ng tao, sino ba talaga ang edukado? Manny never insults the president saling simula. Binabasto siya, sinis**ya, puta**ya, lahat na lang nabato. Sa kay Manny, hanggang ngayon, si Senator hindi pa bumabanat na kabastusan. Kaya nakakapagtaka sa tanong ng lahat, sino ba talaga ang edukado dito?
Several politicians countering President Rodrigo Duterte's claim about Vice President being immune from suit. Over the weekend, the chief executive said that that was one of the reasons why he's planning to run for VP next year, as rivals threaten to file cases against him after his term ends. But former senator and current Sorsogon Governor Chiz Escudero says only presidents are protected from getting sued, according to the Constitution. Bayan Muna Representative Carlos Zarate cites the case of former Vice President Judge Marbinay, who faced plunder charges when he was still in office. For Albay Representative Edsel Lagman, Duterte's ultimate plan is to once again take over as president if an ally wins the post in 2022. Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio defends her recent trips around the Philippines as the pandemic rages. The president's daughter says a decision has to be made about her political career, with or without the health crisis. Duterte Carpio, a rumored presidential candidate in the 2022 elections, has recently traveled to meet with former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo in Pasay City, Governor Gwen Garcia in Cebu, and Zamboanga City Mayor Beng Climaco. But she says her trips were covered by duly filed absences and that she's not neglecting her duties as Davao City Mayor. Vice President Lenny Robredo welcomes the call of several senators to investigate state-sponsored troll farms. During her weekly radio show, Robredo stressed the need for a probe, citing the serious life and death consequences of online misinformation. 12 senators earlier filed a resolution seeking to investigate reports. Public funds are being used to set up troll farms all over the country ahead of the 2022 polls.
Ba yung epekto ng pagkakaroon ng mga troll sa atin? Pinapag-away-away yung mga tao. Hindi ba ka, Eli, ever since naman may mga oposisyon, may administrasyon, pero hindi ganito kagrabe yung away. Mula 2016, magkontra ka sa administrasyon, isa-swarm ka. Isa-swarm ka ng mga trolls. Na ito, yung karapatan mo na pumuna ay... nawawala kasi natatakot yung ibang tao.